वेलकम, माई सेल्फ इज रमना रेड्डी, वर्किंग एज फैकल्टी इन कंप्यूटर साइंस इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट. आई हैव मोर देन 10 इयर्स एक्सपीरियंस इन द टीचिंग फील्ड, मोर देन 10 इयर्स. सो टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ द कॉन्टेक्स्ट फ्री ग्रामर्स. यू नो कॉन्टेक्स्ट फ्री ग्रामर्स आर वेरी पावरफुल ग्रामर्स. These are all exclusively used in defining the syntax of the any high level programming languages, as well as these are all used to verify the syntax of any high level programming language. For example, consider if statement in C programming language. See what is the syntax of the if statement in C programming languages. If open bracket, there is some condition, then close bracket, then open brace and close brace, then some set of statements, then else, then some set of statements. Okay, this is the syntax of the if statement. So this if statement syntax is verified by the compiler with the help of the context free grammars, because the main application of the context free grammars is to design the compiler, particularly one of the phase of the compiler. So that phase is the syntax analysis. Other name for the syntax analysis is the parser. Okay, this is the brief introduction to the context free grammars. As for formal language and automata theory is concerned, let me define what is meant by context free grammar. Generally, any grammar, as for mathematical notations, any grammar is defined by using the G, capital G, that is equals to V, comma, T, comma, P, comma, S. V, T, P, S. Okay. So, how many tuples it's need? So, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, how many tuples you need to define a context-free grammar is 4 tuples. So let me explain one by one tuple. Okay, so the first tuple is the V. So V is the set of variables. V is set of variables. Okay, how you can identify a set of variables, which one is variable in the grammar, is all capital letters and some expressions in programming language and some variable names in the programming language, you can consider as the set of variables. Okay, then next one is the capital T is the set of terminals. Yes, how you can identify terminals in the grammar is all are the small case symbols, zero comma one and some numbers from 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, 9. So all are represented by the terminals. Okay, then P is the set of productions. Okay, we'll see what is meant by a production. Then S is the start symbol. So any grammar, for regular grammar also, these four tuples are mandatory. So first tell me, what are the production formats in the context free grammar? Okay, if you consider the regular grammar, this is the production symbol. For the production, this is the RHS and it is the LHS. Okay, in regular grammar there is two restrictions. LHS must contains exactly one non-terminal, whereas RHS should contain a string of terminal and non-terminal. There are two restrictions, left hand side and right hand side. Okay, but whereas coming to the context free grammar, there is only one restriction. RHS part can contain any symbol, but LHS should contain exactly single non-terminal only. Exactly, single non-terminal only. Okay, so this RHS part can contain a single terminal or non-terminal or followed by terminal or any combination, including epsilon also. Okay, formally we can write like this. For example, A tends to alpha. Yes, A tends to alpha if I write. So where, you know, A belongs to variable, then alpha belongs to variable union T. T means terminal whole closure. Okay, you know what is the symbol that present over this one is, first is, it can be epsilon, a single variable or single terminal or two variables or two terminals or variable terminal or terminal variable or and so on. Okay, any combination you can write to the RHS part. Okay, see, according to Chomsky hierarchy, this context free grammar is called as the type 2 grammar. It's according to the Chomsky hierarchy. So Chomsky is one famous mathematician, research scientist regarding this formal language and automata theory. He classified all grammars and associated their languages and missions. So according to him, Chomsky hierarchy is termed as the type 2 grammar. Okay, you know, context free grammars can develop one language or can be accepted by one language. That language is called as the context free language. In short term, we can write it as CFL. See, grammar is also can write in short form as the CFG. Okay, yes. Then next, first of all, let me tell you why it is termed as context free. So it is the context free. There is some reason is there. Okay, the reason is to the production symbol. This is the, you know, it is RHS, it is the LHS. Okay, in LHS part, for example, I have the production like this. A tends to BC. Basically, it is a context-free grammar because LHS part contains exactly one non-terminal. RHS part can contain two non-terminals. Okay, why it is termed as the context-free is, LHS part, if is there any extra symbol is there, for example, if I am writing A, now A can produce some extra symbols. That extra symbols is called as the context. Okay, again, context is of two types. One is the left context and another one is the right context. Left context and right context. Okay, if I write like this, this is the left context. Okay, for example, if I write like this, it is the right context. Okay, so left context can be replaceable. It can produce some symbols. Right context can be replaceable. It can produce some extra symbols. Okay, so as you know the definition, production form of the context-free grammar, this is the production form of the context-free grammar. Okay, so LHS part exactly single non-terminal. There is no extra symbol. There is no left context. There is no right context. That's why it is the context-free grammar. So this is all about the introduction to the context-free grammar. Take some examples of the context-free grammar. Okay, for example, the language L equals to A closure. Okay, so what is the first possible string over this language is length 0. You can write the first possible string is the epsilon, then length 1 is A, then length 2 is AA, then length 3 is AAA, and so on. Okay, so first it you keep in mind, so first it should generate epsilon, then small a, 2 a's, 3 a's, and so on. This is the language of the strings of symbols. What are those symbols? Is epsilon. Generally, the input for this language is a alphabet a and epsilon also. Alphabet a is only input. Okay, so now we can write the grammar, any grammar start by S. Okay, so it is S tends to epsilon. So we derive the first string. Then what is next one? A. So how we can write it is S tends to A. So I can write A. So instead of, if I want to derive double A, means I cannot write S tends to double A and so on. Instead of that, you can repeat this. So S tends to AS. S tends to AS. Now you can write as a single, because this LHS is common. So you can write it as a single production like S tends to AS slash epsilon. Okay, then consider one more language, the context-free grammar for defining palindrome or A comma B. So A comma B is the input symbols to the language. Okay, all strings must be combinations of A's and B's. Okay, but I'm asking you to write the palindrome. See, what is palindrome? The palindrome is the string reversal is also a string itself. String reversal is also a string itself is the palindrome. Okay, first write all possible strings over this language which is suitable to the palindrome is, so language containing epsilon, then reversal of epsilon is also epsilon, then A, reversal of A is also A, then next B, reversal of B is also a B, then next reversal of double A is double A only, then double B, so reversal of double B is also double B, then A B A, so reversal of A B A is A B A, then next one B A B, so reversal of B A B is B A B only, and so on. So now we can write the context free grammar which can generate all these strings, not only one string. Try with epsilon. So how we can write is starting symbol S tends to epsilon. Then what is next symbol? Next string is A. So how I can write is S tends to A. Then next string is B. So how I can write S tends to B? S tends to B. Yeah, so epsilon A B. Then what is next one? Double A. Okay, double A. So how I can write double A, then double B, A, B, A, B, A, B, and so on. If I have 1,000 symbols, for all 1,000 symbols, you need to write only one context-free grammar. Okay, so how I can write is, I can repeat this. I can repeat A's and B's like S tends to A, S, A. Then next, S tends to B, S, B. Okay. So these are all productions. So LHS is common. So we can write it as a single production rule like S tends to A, S, A, slash B, S, B, slash A, slash B, slash epsilon. This is the context free grammar. Okay. See, I'm not writing B, T, P, S, separately as mathematical definition. See, your production rule itself define the entire context free grammar. Okay, see, how I can write it is, so what are the variables in the grammar? Yes, what is terminals in the grammar? Small a, small b. Okay, then this is the production, then start symbol is yes. Okay, so what my intention here to tell you is, the production rule itself is going to represent the entire variables, terminals and start symbol in the grammar. You no need to write what is G equals to V comma T comma P comma S. Okay, next example language is L of G equals to A power N B power 2N, where N is greater than or equals to 1. Okay, so before writing grammar, first write the language that contains the strings. First identify what are the strings over this language. So I am writing the strings L equals to, let's say if n equals to 1. Okay, so now the string is, so single A, so 2n, it is 2, so now it is double B, so A double B. If I write n is 2, so what is the string is 2 A's, then 4 base, 2 A's and 4 B's. Okay. For example, if I write n equals to 3, n equals to 3. Okay. Now, what is the string is? 3 A's. So, 3 A's. Then, 3 means how many B's? It is the 6 B's. It is the 6 B's. Okay. And so on, and so on. Okay. So, now we need to write the grammar. So, you can directly write the productions. So, any grammar is have the star symbol. I'm taking star symbol is S. Okay. So, S tends to, what is the first possible string is A, B, B. So, I can write S tends to A, B, B. Then next. Next. So, for this string, double A and this one. Okay. So, double A. 4 B's, double A, 4 B's. So, how we can write is so, write like this. You can repeat this one. So, A, S, double B. A, S, double B. Okay. If you want to derive this string, so you can repeat. Okay. The final grammar is S tends to A, double B slash A, S, double B.